Well, we study the seafloor, and in fact, of all the existing studies that have been done in this area in this millennium, they've been conducted by MBARI and my group. The area of interest for this is off Morro Bay. There's the opportunity or the problem of developing wind farms off the coast of California in federal waters. It could provide a substantial amount of energy to the shoreline. On one hand, that would be a way to ameliorate the Earth's largest environmental problem. On the other hand, it's going to do things to the seafloor that many will consider to be quite negative. They're putting turbines offshore. They are considering doing this with a design of turbine which requires it to be in deep water. These would be floating facilities that are being discussed. And these facilities need to be anchored to the seafloor, and then they need a cable that will run back to the shoreline. I also study geohazards, and some of the features that are on the seafloor in this area are the types of features that are usually avoided when you put in cables or seafloor infrastructure. So this is an opportunity to go back and study them further, with now the backstory being that it's of direct societal importance and it'll help inform whether it's a good idea to do this or if it goes forward, what the design of a system should be in order to assure success. We are now working with the USGS, the Bureau of Ocean Energy Management, NOAA, and various California government agencies. The goal is to collect basic geologic information. MBARI's assets are unique for studying the seafloor in detail. Our autonomous underwater vehicles provide maps that are much higher resolution than you can get from any surface ship. The ROVs, of course, are wonderful ways to access the seafloor, to make direct observations, to sample it, and these two couple together in a wonderful way to be able to examine the environment. Things of particular interest are the submarine channels that run down through the slope and pockmarks. And pockmarks are these bizarre depressions on the seafloor. In this area, there are many thousands of them that are approximately 10 meters deep, 100 or 200 meters across, that are on the seafloor. We don't really understand how they form. In this last year, we went back and now using the AUV, we did very detailed surveys of the pockmark field. We studied this in this area before and found no evidence that these were particularly active features. We now need to go back and do this with more assurance because it's of greater importance.